love into the family. He pours love into the home, so his love can overflow into the world. I want to spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life removing pain. Lord, let my words heal a heart that hurts. I want to spend my life mending broken people, so his love can overflow into the world.
God bless you. Welcome back, and happy Wednesday to each and every one of you. For many of you, you already know that on Wednesdays we head over to the 3ABN kitchen. And on this particular day, we are getting ready for Father's Day. And I'm so thankful that to my friend Barbara Kerr is here. She's the president of Taste of Health Ministry. She's come here all the way from Gaston, South Carolina, and she has prepared some very wonderful vegetarian, healthy, but tasty, mouth-watering recipes for Dad. And this is what's on the agenda today. She's going to be making zucchini mushroom pesto panino, simple cabbage slaw, grilled corn with chive butter, chili smoked corn, cinnamon graham sundaes, that sounds interesting, peach streusel pie, and lemonade slush. It sounds fantastic. And if you would like to obtain these recipes, you can just contact our website, 3abn.org, or you can give us a call right here at 3ABN, 1-800-752-3226, and we will be more than happy to send you these recipes. But please stay with us. You know, we really need to make our dads feel special, and you've come to the right place to do that today. So don't go away. You know, one Father's Day, a long, 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 long time ago, in fact, it was so long ago, I was still a teenager, I made this collage of pictures, and I gave it to my dad for a present. And he had it on his wall for a lot of years, but when he passed away 8 years ago, my stepmom gave it back to me. And of course, I've absolutely loved it ever since because of all the memories that are just gathered right here within this frame. This shows Dad holding me and my sister when I was about 3 years old. And it also shows Dad when he took us ice skating. And it shows Dad helping me trying to figure out that camera that I got for Christmas a long time ago. And it even shows Dad with my dog, Charles. Charles was my dog who dug a hole through the kitchen wall in the kitchen. And by the way, we never did really find out what he was looking for. In fact, he was the dog that also ate my high school graduation cake, but we loved him anyway. But when I gave this gift to my dad on that Father's Day a long time ago, this collage of pictures was really saying thank you for being my dad. And thank you that you made so many beautiful memories that formed my image of Dad. But like everyone else's family, our family had its problems too. But the good always outweighed the bad. You know, there's a poem right here in the middle of this collage that I personally picked out from my dad years ago. And this is what it says. Always a father, always a friend, a wonderful someone on whom we depend. Sometimes a comforter quieting fears. Sometimes a banker when we're in arrears. Sometimes a mender of buggies and bikes. Sometimes a vigorous leader of hikes. A teacher, a gardener, a plumber of sorts. A barber, a chauffeur, an expert on sports. A jack of all trades, as the old saying goes. And loved and admired much more than he knows. Just a wonderful someone on whom we depend. Always a father and always a friend. And I really look forward to the time when Jesus comes back in the clouds of glory to take me home, because I have got a big hug awaiting for my dad. But you know what? I am so glad that I honored my dad with plaques and poems like this when he was alive. And I'm so glad that I told him that I loved him on a regular basis, because when we lost him suddenly to a heart attack when he was only 61 years old, you know, there was no unfinished business between us as father and daughter. And maybe today you are one of the fortunate people who still have their dads still living and breathing. And if that's the case, I just want to encourage you to don't waste any time and tell Dad that you love him and honor him with some sentimental gift. Take him out to dinner. Tell him that you really want to spend some time with him. And if something has happened in the past and it's keeping you from loving your dad right now, I just want to encourage you, don't let the devil win by keeping you apart. Just reach out to Dad and love him. You know, that love is going to come back to you in a big way, because love is always contagious. You know, God says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 27, do not withhold good from those to whom it is due. And moms and dads especially need love and deserve love from their children. And I know I've said this before, but it is so true. When God instructs us to do something, it's always because there is an extra special blessing attached. So I just encourage you to go for it. Pick up the phone, jump in the car, go find Dad right now, and just tell him that you love him, honor him, and just appreciate him while you can, because we are never sure what tomorrow will bring. Father, in Jesus' name, I just want to thank you, Father, for the gift of parents. I thank you, Father, for the lessons that we learn through them. I thank you, Lord, for the love that really shines from heaven through them to us. And I just pray, Father, especially for my brothers and sisters who are watching this program today, who still have their fathers with them, perhaps stepfathers, grandfathers. I pray just now that you will bring to mind something special that they can do to honor these fathers in a very special way. I pray that you will help the words just flow out smoothly and easily. Perhaps there's someone watching today who really feels like they stumble over their words when they're trying to express love. I pray, Father, that you will grant them superhuman ability to express their love like never before. Father, once again, we just praise you and thank you for the gift of people, the people around us that really allow your love to shine into our lives in a special way. And I pray, Father, that likewise, that we can, through our lives, allow your love to shine through us in a very special way. And we thank you, Father, once again, for hearing, for answering us as we pray. Amen. Well, right now, Pastor John Loma King, he has a very special Father's Day song, and it's entitled, I Want to Be Just Like You. So come on into our living room and listen to this.
Climbs in my lap for a good night hug. He calls me dad and I call him bud. Faded old pillow, bed ain't poo. He snuggles up close and says, I wanna be like you. So I tuck him in bed and I kiss him goodnight. Tripping over the toys as I turn out the light. I whisper a prayer that someday he'll see. He's got a father in God, 'cause he's seen Jesus in me. Lord, I wanna be just like you, 'cause he wants to be just like me. I wanna be a holy example for his innocent eyes to see. Help me be a living Bible, Lord, that my little boy can read. I wanna be just like you, 'cause he wants to be like me. Got to admit, I've got so far to go. Make so many mistakes, but I'm sure that you know. Sometimes it seems, no matter how hard I try, with all the pressures in life, I just can't get it all right. But I'm trying so hard to learn from the best, being patient and kind, filled with your tenderness. For I know that he learned from the things that he sees, and the Jesus he finds will be the Jesus in me. Lord, I wanna be just like you, 'cause he wants to be just like me. I wanna be a holy example for his innocent eyes to see. Help me be a living Bible, Lord, that my little boy can read. I wanna be just like you, 'cause he wants to be like me. Right now, from where he stands, amazing, mighty tall. But it's all because I'm learning from the best father of them all. Lord, I wanna be just like you, 'cause he wants to be just like me. I wanna be a holy example for his innocent eyes to see. Help me be a living Bible, Lord, that my little boy can read. I wanna be just like you, 'cause he wants to be like me. Oh yes, I wanna be just like you, for he wants to be like me. So between now and then, I wanna be your friend, for he wants to be like me.
Welcome back to the 3ABN Kitchen, and welcome back, Barb.
Thank you.
I tell you, it's always such a privilege for us to have you back at 3ABN. You are such a blessing, and I tell you, I'm looking forward to making a lot of fathers happy around the world.
Oh, good. I am too. Thank you for having me back. You know I love to come and cook in your kitchen. And I loved what you had to say about fathers.
Oh.
That was very nice. And it reminds me a lot of my own father, mm-hmm. and what you said in there, especially about making things right. Dad and I hadn't talked for a couple years because of one of those stupid little arguments that you tend to have when you're an adult, and we've mended the fences, and it's so nice. As a matter of fact, he's coming mm-hmm. to visit in a couple weeks, so I am very happy about that. And I have a couple pictures of my own that I'd like to show you.
Okay, let's do
this.
This
first picture that I'm showing you is one of that was just taken a few months ago at my sister's house, mm-hmm. and so that's a recent photo. And I think I look more like my father than my mother. And I also have a couple pictures I want to show you of me and my dad when I was little.
Okay.
So, aren't I cute?
I think you're precious. In fact, Well, since we're both redheads, you know, I think if you would have put us side by side when we were little, people probably would have thought we were twins.
Especially the ringlet curl picture. I like that a lot. So,
that was a fad or something back then.
I know, my mother every Friday night was combing my hair around her fingers. So, but fathers, our husbands, the men in our lives, we like to have a nice Father's Day special meal, and I have found food just especially for them.
Terrific.
So especially this first one is the panino sandwich. It's a wonderful filled sandwich, and we're going to jump right into it because we have a lot of ingredients.
And this is a recipe that you've tested on your husband.
Mm. I can't remember if he tried it or not. I haven't been home a lot lately. I think Bill did. So I was cooking so fast, you cannot even imagine, Linda. My life is getting fast. I mean, we saw each other one day this month.
Mm-hmm.
That's, I don't know, I don't think you and Danny are apart that much.
No,
It makes it
That's
difficult.
That's very difficult.
Yeah, so, but...
Yeah. But we love them anyway.
Yeah, we love them anyway. So we're going to put the first recipe up for you. It's a zucchini, mushroom, and pesto panino. And you're going to need one medium round whole wheat bread loaf, about 9 inches across, 3 zucchini sliced lengthwise, 3 tablespoons olive oil, 3 2/3 cup portobello mushrooms sliced, 1 garlic clove pressed, 1 teaspoon dried oregano, 3 tablespoons of a pesto, 7 ounces extra firm tofu drained and crumbled, 6 tablespoons of vegenaise, 1 tablespoon Bill's Best Chicknish seasoning, 2 cups of any salad greens, 3 tablespoons of Earth Balance margarine, and a little salt to taste. And this recipe, Linda, is where we're going to grill. We'll start our... Mm-hmm. Our mushrooms first, because we want to get them sauteing. We'll put our Earth Balance in there. And move that aside. And
well, there's those mushrooms again.
Your favorite.
I think I'd like them better if they were prettier. You know,
they
they're
are
just
kind of ugly, aren't they?
I don't know, that the underside of a mushroom reminds me of brains. But I don't know, maybe it's brain food.
I'm just so glad I'm a vegetarian, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
I think about that, the days that I used to eat so much meat. You grew up eating meat, though, too, didn't you?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. And I will never see days again when I go back to that. Major, major change.
You know, every once in a while, if I travel to a foreign country, you see the way they deal with meat. And it's interesting to me when you come across the open bins and literally stuff isn't wrapped and people just paw through it and pick out what they want to eat and mm-hmm. then take that to the counter and pay for it. That to me, it totally grosses mm-hmm. me out. Mm-hmm. So, but,
yes.
You know,
well,
to each his own.
When you think of our bodies as the temple of the living God, too, where the Holy Spirit dwells, you know, we want to put the best in our body temples so that we can be closer to the Lord.
We do. And I know that people that have eaten meat and then stopped for a while and then mm-hmm. they go back maybe 6 months later, they all have the same story. Now, see, when I quit eating meat, I didn't go back, so I don't have that experience. But they say, oh, you feel so heavy. You have this overwhelming kind of headache, sick feeling. Mm-hmm. So I think that's a sign we shouldn't be eating it.
I think so.
Don't you think?
I think so. Well, I've told the story before on the air, but when I was younger, I used to be sick all the time. I used mm-hmm. to have to take every kind of sinus medicine that was available. Aww. I'd have bronchitis every change of season mm-hmm. and just a lot of sinus problems. And when I gave up the meat, mm-hmm. Dropped a lot of the milk products, mm-hmm. I tell you what, all those problems just disappeared.
It's amazing, mm-hmm. especially when you get the dairy out.
Yes.
So, you know, there is a salt shaker on that corn tray over there, if you could get that for me, Linda. We're going to press 1 clove of garlic into our the secret ingredient. Here. Now, I purposefully did not put an amount of salt on the things that are going into the sandwich, but if you grill this without salting it at all, it's going to be very bland and very plain. So you can just salt and season to taste. And I'm going to let you crush our oregano. And my mortar and pestle at home. So I need to get one of those. So if you can, that's not the right kind of, but maybe you can kind of just brings out the flavors in it. Okay. Just attack it, Linda.
I'll do it.
I knew you had it in ya. Okay. We'll get these sauteing and then I'll show you how we make the other part of the sandwich. This is a really nice layered, filled sandwich with zucchini, grilled zucchini that you're going to put in under the broiler. Okay. Can you smell that, how it's already releasing?
But
just,
yes.
You know, put it in your mortar and pestle. Just shake that in here, Linda. And stir it up, and then we'll move on, and I'll show you how to make it.
A lot of healing qualities in oregano.
There are.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me some.
Well, you know, I traveled somewhere, and I was sick, and I was really struggling talking and everything. I got one of those viruses that was going around last winter.
Mm-hmm.
And this person came up to me, and they said, we have got something that will help you tremendously, and it was called Oregamax.
Oh.
And actually, it was like a real condensed version of oregano.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, overnight,
it really helped. Wow.
It really helped.
I believe that there's good stuff in everything the Lord made.
Mm-hmm.
And I take garlic a lot and potty orco, especially when I'm traveling.
Mm-hmm.
And when I go overseas, I don't bring home stuff. Mm-hmm. Where everybody else gets sick, I don't because mm-hmm. I'm really careful and I take good care and I take my garlic and those things that naturally work. Now, the next part of this is you need 3 zucchini that you're going to slice. You can do this with a knife. I happen to have one of these, and I'm very careful, so I don't want anyone here to be afraid. And so you're going to slice your zucchini about quarter of an inch, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to line them on a cookie sheet, and with your olive oil, you're just going to brush both sides of the zucchini
mm-hmm.
and lightly salt them, and then stick them in the broiler for about 5 minutes. Turn mm-hmm. them over, broil them again. You want them to be browning. And here I have some that I broiled this morning, and you know they're nice and crispy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you don't have to make yours as well done as I did. I really like crispy.
Mm-hmm.
So that is that step. Now the next thing we're going to do, Linda, is I would like you to crumble up. This is just half of one of our 17-ounce packages of extra firm tofu. And you can just use your fingers. I don't know that you can. Can you get it like that? Maybe I don't. I keep leaving my Foley fork upstairs. It's because I use it so much, I think. Set this aside.
Speaking of healthy things, Barb, one of these days I want to sell you on seaweed. Now, it's so healthful, especially
like
for women to eat seaweed.
Yeah, I just can't eat
seaweed and flaxseed.
Oh, I eat flax meal. I have 2 tablespoons of flax meal every single morning on my cereal. Oh, that's good. Because there's a reason.
Mm-hmm.
Women especially that consume 2 tablespoons of flax meal a day, they showed this on, it was either 60 Minutes or 2020, don't have any incidents that they found of breast cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's important as women and men, because men get breast cancer too, to take good care of our bodies. And flax meal does so many good things for you that it's just one of those things that's great to add to your daily regime.
You know, in addition to that, I just like the taste of flax seeds. They're really kind of nutty flavor.
It's not bad.
Mm-mm.
No, not at all. Because especially if you mix it, I mix it in with grape nuts or oatmeal or hot nuts.
You know, Barb, Gloria Bain was here recently, and she actually used a ground up flaxseed and water, a mixture of that, to actually be like the egg replacer for a cake.
Yes. Uh-huh.
It was very good.
Yeah, it
was
that
very
works.
Good.
Okay, stir our 1 tablespoon of Bill's Best in, and I think our mushrooms are done, so I'll turn them off. But I need to get our loaf bread ready.
By the way, how did you come up with this recipe?
In a cookbook you got me for Christmas. Really? So, now, with the bread, you need a loaf that is about 9 inches. I actually baked this last night, which wasn't my plan. Mm-hmm. I'd hoped to find one at the store, but no such luck. So, and it was the one time I came here without my cookbook, so I didn't have a recipe. So I just took the Bosch upstairs and just started. I mean, I know what goes in bread, and I just started. Yeah, it made me nervous, dumping stuff in without a recipe.
So, you know, it looks like you did very well, though.
The only problem I had was that I baked in glass, mm-hmm. and I didn't put the right amount of, I didn't flour the bottom, and I had a hard time getting it out. So our other one is a little bit. Now, you're going to want to slice off the top one-third of your loaf. I think I'm getting it a little bit deep here, but... And we'll just set that aside. It looks good
inside. It's beautiful.
And now we're going to cut about 3/4 of an inch from the edge. And we're going to remove the insides. And then you can use this bread that you pull out for, there we go. For breadcrumbs, or you can just save it and
or feed the birds.
Make a sandwich.
Make the birds' day.
Yeah.
Barb, this is gonna make a man-sized sandwich.
I'm telling you, it is delicious. I think I want a little more bread down here. I kind of cleaned out the bread bowl a little bit too much. There we go. Okay, now we're gonna layer this with the stuff that we've got. We've got a little pesto and some salad greens, so pull those over here. And we're gonna do first half of our zucchini, mm-hmm. okay? And you're gonna layer this around the bottom. You wanna completely, I'm gonna cut my zucchini in half. There's nothing quite like the taste of grilled zucchini.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just press that down. And now we're going to take 1.5 tablespoons of our pesto. And you can find, if you can't find a pesto at the store that does not have cheese in it, then just make one out of basil. It's just basil and olive oil, and you can put pine nuts in there. Okay, put that over.
Kind of. Are you ready for
down.
The lettuce?
Nope, not yet. Not yet. That'll be in just a second. Okay, half of our tofu mixture. I call this chicknish cheese. this is my cheese recipe for lasagnas, whenever you need a mozzarella cheese or ricotta cheese. I'm almost ready for you. And we're just gonna use about a big handful, like a cup's worth. Okay, now we need a handful of the salad greens. Maybe just a few more. Okay. Now.
And by the way, when you're choosing lettuce, the greener the better, right, Barb?
That's right.
And this is the spring mix, the salad blend of tender baby greens.
You could use romaine.
It's fantastic as far as vitamins and minerals are concerned.
Okay, now we want to put in all of the mushroom mixture. Normally you would wait until your mushrooms have completely cooled. Okay.
What kind of mushrooms are those?
These are portobello. Mm-hmm. And portobello are immune boosting mushrooms. So they're good for you too, even though they're ugly.
Yeah, leave a little to be desired on appearance.
Looks aren't everything. Okay, now give me another handful of salad leaves.
Okay.
Okay, and now we're going to top this with the rest, our remaining tofu. I'm going to make sure I didn't leave anything out. Okay.
That looks terrific.
Salad doesn't want to cooperate. Okay. Now
I'm anxious to see how you serve this, because surely you don't put this on one man's plate.
and say, eat it.
You don't think Danny, I bet there's some.
There's probably some men out there could eat the whole thing.
That. No, we, as a matter of fact, my friend Claudia has been taking care of Nathan because Bill and I have both been traveling a lot. He has salesman problems. I just have, busy problems. And so she was the one that she taste tested this, now that I remember. And then the rest of our pesto goes in the center. Now, if you have a really small loaf, you can cut some of this out, but you don't. It just depends on the bread you end up working with.
Oh, it smells wonderful.
Wait till you taste it. And then you're going to wrap this up tightly with some kind of plastic wrap. I'm not sure if I got that back together right. Okay. Wrap this up tightly with plastic and put it in the fridge. It's best if you can put it in overnight. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then you have this nice, and you can feel how heavy it is. Go ahead and start to unwrap that, but carefully, because I pulled a little bit of the bottom of that bread out last night. So I thought I would use it as our example today. Get rid of this. And I will show you how beautiful this is. And we'll slice up. And then to serve it, you're going to cut it into wedges. And no, you would not want to eat.
So you put it in the refrigerator overnight so the flavors really get into the bread and into each other.
And you there's
that really looks like a great sandwich.
Doesn't it? It looks great.
It looks very good.
So just cutting a wedge, a small wedge, makes it a lot.
I better taste it. And just to make sure, Barb, that it tastes as good as it looks.
Sorry about that. Okay. It's messy.
Good job.
Thank you.
Good job.
I think this is one of those winter sandwiches.
You know,
this takes about an hour to put
this
together.
This is the real manwich. All others are artificial.
That's right.
This is really what you call a manwich.
It's beautiful.
Women like them too.
That's right. So a 9-inch loaf of bread across the bottom is what you're looking for. Anything smaller, you're going to have to do half a recipe. So.
Oh.
Are you ready for our simple cabbage slaw?
Yeah, let's go on
to the
next
recipe. Okay, you
want to
go ahead and read those ingredients?
Sure. For the slaw, you will need a one-pound bag of coleslaw mix, one medium sweet red or green pepper finely chopped, 1/2 cup plus 2 tablespoons of milled cane sugar, 1/2 cup of lemon juice, 1/2 cup of water, 1/4 teaspoon of salt.
And that's all that's in it. It's very simple. You can see how hard this was, Linda.
Well, I thought I saw you upstairs just chopping.
I was. Don't tell anybody. And my assistant chopped this red pepper for me. So, isn't that beautiful?
We need to eat coleslaw every day, though, because cabbage is such a cancer fighter.
It's good for you, and it's filling. It stays with you a long time if you have cabbage every day. So I'm going to have you mix up the dressing part. Yeah. The milled cane sugar is 1/2 cup plus
now,
2 tablespoons.
Now, once again, what's the difference between milled cane sugar and regular sugar for our viewers who haven't heard about that yet?
I'm trying to get a regular sugar plant to let me in, but so far I've not had any luck. I'd like to see what they really do in there. But milled cane sugar is the pressed juice from the sugar cane, and then they dehydrate it, evaporate it, and you have
take all the good stuff out of it.
Yeah, so it's always a little brown because of the vitamins that you see in there. Mm-hmm. We've added 1/2 cup of real lemon juice, not the concentrate, 1/2 cup of water, and we're putting in just 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Mm-hmm. So.
But actually, the milled cane sugar, it tastes to me, just as sweet as sugar, only you're getting all the natural vitamins and minerals. Your body can recognize it and process it much easier and better. And
but
so
you
why
should
not?
Still always use, you know, not overdo it with anything like that, even honey or fructose or anything like that. Go ahead and pour that over our cabbage mixture, Linda. And then you're just going to let this sit in the fridge again overnight or for several hours. And I mix it up. And
that's
once you mix it, and it, well, you can see I made it in the same, actually the same dish earlier. It will shrink up, and then you have your coleslaw.
Looks fantastic.
So without the mayonnaise part of it, too. So you don't have the fat of the mayonnaise-based coleslaw in here. So very delicious. Now, we have a couple corn recipes for you. We're going to make a grilled corn with chive butter first, and we're going to follow that with a chili smoked corn. So let's put the ingredients up for you now. You're going to need 6 medium ears of sweet corn, 1/2 cup earth balance margarine melted, 2 tablespoons of snipped chives, 1 tablespoon of milled cane sugar, 1 1/2 teaspoons lemon juice, and salt to taste.
You know, Barb, this reminds me so much when I was a kid. We used to have block parties. Have you ever participated in a block party?
I don't think so, but it sounds like fun.
Well, like in a neighborhood, the entire block would get together and they would have a corn roast in the summertime. And they would actually make, they would dig a hole in the ground and get a fire going and then put the corn that was all wrapped in aluminum foil in there and cover it up. And it was just so much fun. It really was.
Do you ever go camping and do that? You know, put your potatoes and your corn down in the coals and...
No. Well, Dan and I travel a lot, but we don't get to camp too often.
I don't either, because every time I've done it, it doesn't come out. I either overcook it. I mean, you can't control that temperature, so it's an environment.
Well, see, you know, we all have areas where we can grow, right?
That's right.
You're going to have to grow into the
campfire. You come down and go. We'll go camping together. Now, all I've done is soaked the corn for, you can soak it for an hour. I've actually soaked this overnight, so that's okay. And then you just want to peel it back to within an inch of the bottom, okay? Have your ears ready. These were beautiful looking, I thought, at the store. Take your earth balance margarine, that was 1/2 cup, and we're going to mix in our milled cane sugar just to give it a little sweetness, our 2 tablespoons of chives. Fresh chives are in season all summer long. A little lemon juice, that's 1 1/2 teaspoons. And I actually am going to put the salt right on the corn itself. So I'll show you how we're going to do this. And this is one, again, that depending on what your tastes are, you know, you're going to brush this right onto the corn. And then...
Let's talk a little bit about the margarine once again. Now, this is not your typical butter that you're going to buy at the store.
No, and also a lot of margarines I would never eat either. This is a non-hydrogenated fat margarine, and I really like the earth balance, and that's why you see me using it in recipes. Not only that, it has a great flavor. It doesn't taste like a health food margarine, you know. So your body actually recognizes it as a food, not a
fat.
Well, no, it'll I mean, there's fat in it. There's less than butter. I mean,
but it's not a bad fat.
Right, exactly. And anything that a lot of margarines are made from hydrogenated fat, which is something your body doesn't really recognize. So, if you'll pull us out a sheet of aluminum, I'll show you. We're just going to wrap this around. Now, you can tie this with string here, okay? Put it on your grill and grill this for 25 to 30 minutes, turning it. Or you can, if you don't have your grill, you want to just wrap it in a little aluminum, okay? You can bake this in the oven like I did today because I didn't have a grill. Bake it in the oven. I baked it at 425 degrees for 30 minutes. And let's open one up and see how it turned out because I didn't even peek on it. So I hope it's still, I wanted a surprise.
It is a surprise.
And then you can peel this back, but it keeps some moisture in. And then, of course, if you want to add more salt or butter, but doesn't that just look,
it
and then
looks
you have the
wonderful
flavor of the chives.
That is a beautiful ear.
Why, thank you.
That is a beautiful ear.
So
but
that's
since we're into corn, why don't we put up our next corn recipe?
Yes. And that is our chili smoked corn. You're going to need 8 large ears of sweet corn husked, 1/2 cup of Bakos, 2 tablespoons chili powder, earth balance margarine melted, and salt to taste again.
Now, speaking of Bakos.
Yes. This is not,
pork is probably one of the most unhealthy things that you can put within your body. Now with Bakos, it is not a meat product.
No, absolutely not. It's totally vegetable protein that they've given a flavor. And you can even, it has a sort of a bacon scent, smell, mm-hmm. don't you think? Do you eat them? I like them sprinkled on salads. I don't eat them all the time.
Uh-huh.
But we need a piece of foil again for this, Linda.
Okay.
And this again is very simple. Simple recipe. To start out with this, again, you're going to put your margarine on to taste. Now, I would never do this to corn for myself at home. Mm-hmm. I like it just like that. I know I'm mm-hmm. strange, but if you eat it raw, you don't need butter and salt on corn. If you can find a nice looking ear like this.
You know,
this
I really like raw corn myself. It has a wonderful flavor. And
it's nice and sweet.
Mm-hmm. But if you're going to have people over to your house, it would be a little strange
if you
served raw corn.
I don't do that. If you come over for dinner, I'll be cooking the corn for you. Just sprinkle it lightly with chili powder, okay? This is not your super hot chili powder. And then 1 tablespoon of Bakos per piece of corn. And just sprinkle some on there. Gives it a little different flavor. Wrap it up. Again, you can grill this on the grill, turning it, or bake it 425 degrees for 30 minutes.
And here's the finished product right here.
And the Bakos were going to look a little bit, mm-hmm. they get a little soft looking. Yeah, but
smells fantastic.
Tasty.
So, yes. We're going to make those dads happy.
Yeah, I wanted to give you some different options for mm-hmm. corn because, you know, it is summertime after all.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Sure.
Anyways, okay. We have a wonderful dessert. We're going to put up one recipe that we're not going to show you today called it's cinnamon graham sundaes. And for this, you're going to need, let me go ahead and read those ingredients. It's just
okay, you will need 20 cinnamon graham cracker squares, 1/2 gallon of better than ice cream prepared, and both of those things you can get at your health food store, 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon, 3 tablespoons of honey.
And this is very simple. All you do is take 1/2 of your graham cracker, put it on a plate, top it with a spoon of ice cream, sprinkle with cinnamon, drizzle with honey, top it with the other graham cracker, and that's all there is to it.
That is simple.
But what we're going to make today is the peach streusel pie. And this one is delicious. Now, you're going to need for the filling, first a pastry for a single crust pie. You want that to be 9-inch deep dish. And then 1/4 cup fructose, 1/4 cup cornstarch, 2 tablespoons lemon juice, 4 cups of sliced fresh or frozen peaches thawed. For the topping, you'll need 1/2 cup granola cereal without raisins, 1/4 cup whole wheat pastry flour, 1 teaspoon ground cinnamon, 1/4 cup earth balance margarine, and 2/3 cup sucanat. Now, once you taste this, Linda, there's no going back. You're committed to the whole piece.
I guarantee my husband would love this one.
Now, this is another shortcut that I took. Because now in the grocery store, you can get all vegetable. There's no lard in the pie crust. So if I'm in a hurry and I don't want to make it myself, and I don't always want to make it myself, I'll just buy the 9-inch deep dish. Now you do need to line it with a double piece of foil. Okay, you want to bake this at 450 degrees for 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. Then you take the foil out and bake it for another 5 minutes and then pull it out of the oven.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to, with our peaches, I'll set this aside. I've decided to do something I haven't done here before, and that is change the recipe on the air. I made this again, and I still think it's too thin.
Barb, variety is the spice of life.
So as a matter of fact, more people, I'm changing it. So,
well, that's
we're
cool.
gonna do that.
That's
we're
cool.
gonna do it the same. I'm gonna cook it on the stove and let it thicken on the stove before I put it in the crust.
Okay.
That's our change.
All right.
So the ingredients are gonna stay the same. Okay, Linda, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, in this bowl you need a little spoon and dissolve our fructose, which is let me go back to my ingredient list. A quarter cup fructose and a quarter cup cornstarch. Stir them together first, and then we're going to add our 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Don't make a mess.
It's too late.
Too late. Look good on our black slacks.
Okay.
Okay. And then that will make a nice thick. I'll give you
a little lemon juice.
Mm-hmm. That dissolves, and then
this is really going to make our peach sauce.
Yeah, it's going to be thicken the pie, mm-hmm. And then I'm going to stir this into what's boiling, and hopefully it won't be a disaster right on the air. And if it is, oh well.
I suspect it's going to work, Barb.
Okay.
You have been cooking for many, many years.
If it doesn't
now.
Lump up because my liquid's already boiling, I'll be okay. But it might. Okay. I just want it. And the 2 1-pound bags work great. Give you just 4 cups of peaches. So, this spoils, it'll thicken. Now, I want you to make up our topping for us, Linda.
Okay.
We need. I don't remember exactly. I think it's 1/2 cup of granola. I'll look at those while you add them. That's granola without raisins. You can make your own. Or 2/3 cup of sucanat. That's the milled cane sugar with the blackstrap molasses added back to it. That's really mm-hmm. nice and full of vitamins.
Okay. Then we have our flour.
Yes, 1/4 cup of whole wheat pastry flour. And 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon. And 1/4 cup of the earthbound margarine. Here, this looks much thicker. And then you just have to, cut that out. And then the topping, I'll let you work on that because you need to crunch it down and really get it coated well. I'm going to put our peaches into our pie crust while you do that. I forgot, I'm glad I turned that off. Stuck my paper right into the burner. Okay, yeah, this looks better because now as it bakes, it's gonna
mm-hmm.
not
it's
get
already.
Too. I'm just having trouble with it getting too juicy in the oven, and then this is still gonna taste the same.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Sometimes you need to just follow your instinct.
That's right. Well, and actually when you're cooking is so individual because of your family members and what they like and what they don't
mm-hmm.
like. And so you add a little of this and take away a little of that.
That's right. Now, I like this because it doesn't have, got that all?
Yeah.
That looks good. Doesn't have a second crust that you have to make. I don't like making pie crust. But I do like a streusel topping goes together in 5 minutes.
You know, we've actually, in our travels, we've visited and ate with a lot of different families. You know, in several families where we've been, they've actually served like a peach crisp for
mm-hmm.
breakfast. But, you know, you have your granola,
yeah.
you have your fruit, and you have your whole wheat, so you have your grains and and your fruit mixed together. And let me tell you, it sure tastes good.
Dessert for breakfast.
Yeah.
Life short, eat dessert first. Was that the motto they were feeding you by?
Okay, well, it worked.
It did. Now, you're just going to stick this right into the oven. Let me put that here and pull out our, we've got one right there that we'll slice up, Linda.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, we better taste test this, Barb.
Yeah.
There's no telling.
But you can see, and maybe this one will do the same thing, but I don't think so now. You can see I put it on a cookie sheet,
mm-hmm.
So that it wouldn't run over, but it's or to catch it if it did, and it did. It didn't disappoint me. It might be a little.
It looks fantastic.
I love a good peach pie.
Mm-hmm.
This one, the crust is going to be a little soft because I made it last
night. I'm going to have to make this for my husband for Father's Day. Really, I think he will like this very much.
I think he will too. There's nothing in here I don't think that Well, this one's not going to be so pretty, but got a little plate.
The first piece. Now, I suspect your son is probably one of your A number one taste testers.
Oh, he loves to taste test. Now, this is not maybe as pretty as it could be, but okay. I think the taste will be there, like the peach cobbler.
I'm going to try it.
It is wonderful.
Good?
Fit for a queen. But since
Danny.
We're talking about fathers, we'll say king.
Okay.
It's fantastic.
I think peaches.
We do have one more
we
recipe.
We have a drink. Yes, it's. You're going to love it. It's a lemonade slush. I even really like this one, too. I mean, I like all my recipes, but I don't usually drink the drinks, but I drank the whole glass. You're going to need 2/3 cup lemonade concentrate, partially thawed, 1 cup of the French vanilla silk creamer, 2/3 cup of water, and 12 ice cubes. You know, Linda, I think I forgot to tell everyone to bake the pie at 375 degrees for 30 minutes.
Okay.
So,
okay. 375 for 30 minutes.
Yeah, in case I forgot that. So, okay. I wouldn't rest well tonight. I think of it as I lay down, actually. So, this is very simple. We're going to start with my favorite ingredient, the French vanilla silk creamer. That's 1 cup. And then we've got 2/3 cup of lemonade concentrate.
Now, how did you come up with this recipe?
You know, I kind of cheated. I was so, you know, I told you I was only home one day this month. Mm-hmm. I called my wonderful, sweet, and darling mother mm-hmm. and said, help me. Mm-hmm. Help me research some recipes, Mom. And she did. She found all the recipes for me that we could make alterations to, and she did. And then she sent them to me, typed them into the computer. You are a saint, Mom.
She's a real peach.
She's a keeper. Okay, we're just going to blend that up. So she found them all, and I just did all the alterations. So, how about one more time?
One more time.
Now, if your lemonade concentrate's a little more frozen than ours was, it'll be a little more slushy. The other mm-hmm. thing I did with this recipe was I took the blender and I stuck it in the freezer for a little while, a couple mm-hmm. hours, and then I brought it back and re-blended it and made it more like a slush. Well, that's plenty. This is very tangy, sweet, and tart.
You know, it looks like it's a very different recipe. Because I've never thought of the French vanilla with the lemon.
Oh, it's good. And this would be good, I think, with limeade, too.
Okay.
So we'll have to try it. Give ourselves a little moustache.
That's delicious.
Isn't this good?
It's
I like
very
this. This is
good.
Almost like dessert.
You know, actually, all your recipes today, don't save them for just Father's Day. You're going to want to use them all year round because they're fantastic. You did a great job, Barb.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Before we go to our break, tell me, is there a favorite dad moment that just stands out in your mind that you'd like to share?
You know, there is one that I can think of. When I was about 9 years old, we were on a trip to Catalina Island, and I had just been followed by a group of dolphins. We stopped the boat, and we were all looking at the water, and my father reached over and shoved me in. And I will never forget that. And so that actually is a favorite dad moment, you know?
You loved it?
I wanted to get in the water. Uh-huh. And I think he could probably tell that, so he just gave me that little shove. Uh-huh. So, but that was kind of fun. You didn't expect that, did you?
I didn't expect that.
So thanks, Dad.
Do you know what, though? Kids like to get in with dolphins
right.
and stuff. Of course, now that I'm an adult and Dan and I went to the Cayman Islands, mm-hmm. and we went to Stingray Bay. You know, I never had that urge to get out with the stingrays. You know, I think you kind of outgrow, you know, some of that, and you realize there's a little bit of danger there.
I went there 2 months ago.
Did you get in with the stingrays?
I did. I swam with them. Hey, I showed a picture.
You're braver than I am.
Chicken. We'll have to go together.
Yes. So. Well, Barb, you have a terrific cookbook.
Fantastic cookbook,
in fact. And we're going to give you Barb's address right now so you can write to her and contact her.
If you'd like more information on how to obtain Barbara Kerr's cookbook, A Taste of Health, please have a pen and paper ready to take down the following information. You may contact her by writing to Taste of Health Ministries, Post Office Box 38, Gaston, South Carolina, 29053. That's Taste of Health Ministries, Post Office Box 38, Gaston, South Carolina, 29053. Or call her at 803-936-1714. That's 803-936-1714. Visit her website for recipes, news, and a whole lot more at tasteofhealth.net. That's tasteofhealth.net.
You know, Linda, recently for my website, I purchased barbarakerr.org and barbarakerr.net. So if people want to look me up by my name, they can do that too.
That's wonderful.
So it will automatically take you to Taste of Health.
Mm-hmm. And the ministry that you have is so awesome. I was thinking of this Chinese saying that they have, and they say that once you share a meal together with a stranger, that they will be a friend forever.
Oh, I like that saying.
And it is so true. So make some friends with these recipes, and also use these recipes to share Jesus. And until next time, we just want to leave you with this thought. May the Lord richly bless you abundantly more than you can ever ask or think. And we look forward to seeing you next time on our Wednesday cooking here in the 3ABN kitchen. Bye-bye.
Thank you for being our family.
Thank you.
May God